you can see, this bumper, there's not much of it. It's just sheet metal. I hate sawzalling. I hate sawzalling. So for this project, I've had this for a while, but it's a 4,500 pound winch that we're going to put on the back of it. And the idea with that is, I've gotten into situations where, because the cab and the approach angle on this is very steep, that when you're going down into a ditch, you'll bottom out on the front bumper and the whatnot. So the idea with this is I'll be able to pull myself out backwards without needing somebody else to be there. Also, what we're going to do is we're going to have these LED lights that we're going to put in it. It's got brake, turn signal, and backup lights. And then I might use these bolt-on D-rings that, apparently they're 12,000 pounds. I doubt that whatever bolts you use are rated for that, but we might use that because I use those on the front. So if I want to, you know, match the front, those are what I'm going to use. As you can see here, I'm going to use some cardboard, and basically we're going to make a simple template that we can fit up to where we need to bolt the main support. And this gives us exact dimensions of what we need for our first part, which is basically the frame support. So with my comment about being able to do this at home in your driveway, with the services like sand cut sand and exometry, you can do basically everything that you need to on your home computer, and then design their parts and send them off to get cut and bent and shipped to you. So you don't need any special laser cutter or anything of that nature. So in this video, I'm using my own equipment, but you can use services like that to do it at home if you don't have this kind of equipment. Now that we have the cardboard cutout, the way we get this into a CAD program is two ways. Either you can take each measurement and go point to point, or you could take a picture of this, trace out the lines on the picture, then delete the picture, and then you're going to stretch it in the X direction and the Y direction. And the reason you want to do that is because the picture is not going to be one-to-one, and that's based on whatever camera you use, the lens, things of that nature. So to stretch it is key to use a picture. What I'm going to do is I'm literally going to put it on my CNC table, and because I have a light, a laser light, I'm just going to move the table over and take each point and record those points and then put that in a CAD. That way I have a one-to-one representation of exactly what's going on. So that's the way I'm going to do it.
Don't forget to check out my other video of how I put this laser cutter on a CNC plasma table. Link in the description.
No, I can't. I can't. Oh, stop tempting me. No, I can't. I can't. I want to go over a mistake I made. I design in 2D CAD because it's easier to design these parts for the CNC plasma table and it's quicker. But if you're doing this in 3D CAD, this was a mistake that you'd probably not make. But in 2D CAD, just a heads up, if you're going to do a bend like this where you got an angle, always remember to do the next angle at a perpendicular 90 degree. This is where I messed up. As you could see, it won't fit on a flat plane. Where this one, I fixed it and it's going to fit on a flat plane. So that, not this wheel. So 2D CAD, just remember that you have to offset your next bend angles at a 90 of the angle you're going to do, where you know, in 3D CAD you would probably catch this in your model. So I made these tabs that bolt into the already tabs that I have right here, and then that's what's actually going to hold the brake light in. And then I have the strengtheners that are going to come from here and bolt up here to the mount, as you can see. And that will strengthen the D-ring. And then over here I'll have this to strengthen the same kind of idea, strengthen the winch mount. So that should triangulate all the heavy stress areas. And then using the tabs to basically mount the bracket or the taillights in. And this bumper is pretty much ready for paint without any welding. We'll be right back.
really pleased on how this turned out. The bumper is stronger than the truck that it's bolted to, and I look forward to using this to get me out of some sticky situations.